Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the second part of my Flyhawk Models 1700 scale HMS Prince of Wales build. Right, so last time we had a good look at the kit and put the turrets together. It's time to take this build further, but before we start off, please do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and do click the bell icon to keep informed about future posts on the channel. Also, I love to hear from you, so do keep the comments coming. Time now to start working on the first superstructure. This comprises three deck levels, each smaller than the lower one, with many tiny parts to be added. Mostly machine guns, searchlights, binoculars, and such like. Gluing in all these tiny parts took a lot longer than I thought it would. There was always a threat of losing them, so I had to remain focused and concentrate hard. Also, these parts are so small and fragile that even the super thin cement can melt them. So one more reason to be extra careful and take one's time. Now for the first photo etch part. The antenna on top of this, what I believe, is either the rangefinder or the main battery director. As you can see, the parts are really tiny and very delicate. I have found that often while dealing with super tiny parts like here, it is best to set the instructions to one side and rely on experience and understanding of one's own skill limits. Here the instructions indicate that the antenna should be made up of two parts. This tiny upper part and this even tinier base. The base is then to be glued to the original plastic part. Here is the base in the photo etch set. I don't know about more accomplished modelers, but knowing myself, there is no way I will ever be able to get this fragile base to stick in place correctly, and then stay in place for the remainder of the build. So my solution is pretty simple. I will only replace the top antenna part and retain the plastic base. This should provide for a much more stronger bond. And now the piece can be glued to the superstructure. Here is a quick comparison with the original plastic piece. Next, let's put together this photo etch ladder. The foot plates of the ladder need to be bent out. I find it easier to do so while the ladder is still attached to the photo etch set. This prevents the ladder from getting warped out of shape when pressure is applied. And now the ladder is glued in place with some super glue. I keep adding tiny pieces to build up the superstructure. The next intricate photo etch assembly is this radar. The plastic piece is cut off and replaced by more detailed photo etch parts. To bend the railing in a perfect circle, I first find a brush with roughly the same diameter. I use the radar's base plate to get a good idea about the diameter. Next, I use this soft polishing stick as a base and the brush to bend the railing into a circle. Final finishing touches are made with a cocktail stick. Right, looks much better. Finally, the outer railing is bent in the same way. Now for the bigger range finding antenna. These ones are made of three parts. However, since they are bigger and relatively more sturdy than the smaller ones I made earlier, I am using all the three parts. Also, these are relatively bigger and the details are clearly visible, so worth the effort. Finally, I glue in place all the levels of the superstructure together. I really like the detailing and finish. Now on to the second superstructure, this one with the hangar doors and the smoke funnel. So these pieces on top of the smoke funnels, I have never been able to bend them correctly. I think it's mostly because it's a compound bend, if I can call it that. What I mean is that each arm on the photo etch part has to be bent independently at a unique angle. Getting all of them at the correct angle with the correct bend is very difficult. Anyway, I tried a new approach this time, which was to use the plastic piece as a template to bend the piece on. It worked, to an extent. Another problem was that once I cut the plastic bracing inside, the piece became very fragile and bendy. So I had to glue it to the funnel for some structural support. I then cleaned up the plastic piece. Lastly, the photo etch part was glued in. You can see, they may not be perfect, but they are much better than my earlier attempts. I think using the plastic piece as a template really works, and is something that can be improved upon with practice. I now put together the masts. What I did not realize at this point was that these masts are really fragile and the plastic is way too soft. So much so that once other parts were glued on them, especially the rigging, the masts got bent out of shape. This was a shame. I realized this much later in the build. However, in case you want to do some rigging on your ship, you should look to change these plastic masts with brass rods. In fact, you should just change these masts anyway. They're just too clumsy and look bad on an otherwise very nicely detailed kit. After adding the photo etch parts to the mast, in my over-eagerness, I decided to glue it in place. This was a big mistake. The mast is supposed to go through the floor of the adjoining superstructure. I realized this later, and while it is a mistake, it was rather easily corrected by cutting the mast's legs and then reattaching them. I will show this later when we get to the part. However, one good thing to come from this mistake was that it provided a much more stable base for the mast, and it made attaching more photo etch pieces easier. And here I realize that I have glued the mast in prematurely. So I'm forced to cut the legs off. Some dry fitting to ensure that I don't make any further mistakes. And now finally the two superstructures are glued in place. And finally, the mast is also glued in. It all looks really nice so far. Well then, fellow model makers, that's about all the time we have in this edition. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please do hit the like button and do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Every like and every comment really helps, so don't be shy. I guess that about wraps it up for now. Hope to see you soon in the next episode of The Build. Till then, stay safe, good luck, and happy model making.